Let's see. Oh, this is what I meant to watch with y'all, actually. Hold on, before we get out of here. There's a video. Okay, now, since whatchamacallit, the song was song. Since Valentine's Day is coming up, let's have a debate. Let's have a debate. A small debate. Ding ding. Welcome to my courthouse. So this video is from Jubilee. And the topic of discussion is the idea of virginity outdated, and virgins versus non-virgins have virgins virgins versus non-virgins, not virgins, have a conversation about it. So let's talk about it. Why did it sound like that? Valentine's Day, I'm allergic. No you're not. Everyone, this video was tested for COVID. Good job. They're vaccinated. That's right. Content warning. The following episode contains discussion of sensitive subjects, such matters such as sexual assault. Please be aware of the content warning. That's what they're going to be talking about. If that makes you uncomfortable, please take care of yourself and your mental health. And I'm sure I will see you next time.
I started hope.
Okay. All right. That's crazy. I was going to raise you after this. Yeah. All right, I appreciate you, Crazy and Timmy. Right, y'all came at a wild ass time. We watching some debates. Thank you for the resub. Oh my gosh, for 11 months, almost a year. That's right. I approve of it. Thank you so much for the raid, Queen. I hope you had an amazing stream. I hope you had an amazing stream there. He said, run back the beginning of the video for those of you who are coming from our stream. We are watching we just finished playing the back room. So now, after being scared out of my ass, that's right, my crack ass is going to watch this video. And I don't like that sound. I don't know why that makes my skin crawl. There is a, this video is a debate about the idea of virginity outdated. So we're going to have a little conversation. Here's a content warning. For the following episode contains such discussion of sensitive subject matter such as sexual assault. Viewer discretion is advised. So please advise. Please advise. And like I said, if this is something that you are uncomfortable with, please take care of yourself first and click out of this video. I will see you next stream. You said it sounds like a video game. Yeah, it does sound like a video game intro, which is why I hated playing video games back in the day, but I loved it. Always did like this whenever I started up a console.
I started poking her, just joking around. That's just how I am, you know? She took my hand and she licked my finger.
Oh, okay.
And I was like,
God.
I was like, what do you think we're doing? We're just chilling, like.
I am a virgin because I am asexual and haven't really had a desire to have sex yet.
Being a virgin is really important to me because it's a significant part of my religion.
I think there's definitely a lot of assumptions made about people who are virgins. I think my favorite one is the idea that people think you can look like a virgin.
My friends have always been wanting me to lose it. My friend wanted me to have sex.
That's one thing that I would like to have a topic about. Is like, why are friends always trying to make their friends lose their virginity? Is it like, y'all trying to start a cult? Or like stop trying to make your friends do it. That's very uncomfortable. As somebody's friend, you should never try to peer pressure anyone into losing their virginity. So they can be cool. That's fucking gross.
Sex with his cousin.
If you had your virginity intact still in my high school environment, they sort of just...
Just so you could have something to talk about. There's plenty of other things to talk about between each other as friends. I mean, I get it. Like, you know, once your friend loses their virginity, they want to tell you about it. They'll be like, hey, you know, my first time it happened, blah, blah, blah. And that's cool. That's fine. But it's not like, now that I lost mine, you need to lose yours. Like, no. No.
Ignored you.
No.
When people heard, like, through the grapevine, oh, that so-and-so had sex, it was always seen as a bad thing.
It is mandatory that we keep ourselves pure until marriage.
I lost my virginity at 15 at a party in a garage.
Oh. Okay. It's not even cool. It's mid. Wish I had mine still. I'll tell y'all my personal view on virginity in a little bit.
I'm Bree. I'm a musician and content creator.
Nice.
Hi.
Okay, what's up, Bree? Bro, what's her YouTube? She look kind of cool. She remind me of Ash Nico. Y'all don't know anything about her.
Hi, guys. My name is Rahan, and I'm a virgin.
My name's Skylar. I'm just a normal dude.
I'm just a normal dude.
Hi, I'm Kiani. I'm an artist, and I'm also getting a degree in marine biology, and I'm a non-virgin.
Hi, I'm Vanessa. I study psychology and theater, and I am a non-virgin.
I'm Nico. I'm 19, and I'm really
scared. Hey, Jen, there go Nico! Oh,
if you agree with the statement, please.
Are they already trying to walk forward?
I feel or felt ready to lose my virginity.
How's his name spelled? It's not spelled the same. It's N-I-C-O.
I've always been ready. I just never really found the right person. And I'm not someone that's very, it doesn't really matter who it is.
But I just want there to be some
sort of connection between us. I'm not just gonna like hit it and just like, all right, you can go home, kick them out. You
know? Oh, y'all know about Ash Nico? Okay, y'all are cool. Y'all can sit at my table. No.
That makes sense.
I mean, sit at my table.
At the time, you were ready? Because they're like, she look good, I look good. It's time. It's, okay. I'm ready.
Did you know the person for a good while before you guys?
I knew her for a time. Name
one Ash Nico song. No, I'm kidding. Yes, you can sit at the table.
I knew her longer. It was my first high school party. The whole time I was feeling like, dang, this is my first time. I don't know what to do. It was like, I don't know what to do.
Hey, he got the Brilisi screeners on.
Did she expect me to do everything? it was a lot of stress. I just remember it being super stressful.
Yeah.
I think I was sweating. And then, like, I wasn't even sweating because of sex. I was just sweating. Like, I couldn't even put the condom on right. It was like, it was just what it was.
Interesting. I identify as asexual, and I've never really felt comfortable in the past.
For people who don't know what asexual is, someone who does not experience sexual attraction or an intrinsic desire to have sexual relationships. So basically, they have no desire whatsoever to have sex, and that is very valid. I don't know how that comes about, if that's just, like, something that happens, like, I heard that it can be trauma induced, but some people are just like that. So,
couple years or when I was
play
in college,
games, probably
lose my virginity versus now I've come to a place where I'm more of like a sex positive asexual would be the term. And if I had a partner nowadays or someone that I like deeply connected with, I would be down to the idea of it, but it's still not something I'm like seeking out or whatever.
Yeah,
but
exactly.
If like my partner was like, yo, this could be like fun or something, and if I would do something random with them, like maybe I would. Have sex.
Have sex. Oh yeah, she made content.
So the question was, do you feel ready to lose your virginity? And for myself, I am not ready because I am Muslim, and technically you're only allowed to lose your virginity or be intimate with anyone once you're married. So I am not married, nor am I in a relationship, or have I ever been in a relationship. So I am just saving myself, saving everything until marriage. So once I get to that point in my life, then I'd be ready to do that the right way with my partner.
Okay.
When
okay.
I first lost my virginity, I remember it was like talking
what's her name?
To
the
a guy
girl
for
with the
couple
blue hair?
Days on Tinder. He was just like, I have a place. Do you want to come over? It finally happened. We get into the room and it just sort of starts happening. And I was just like, take a deep breath, ask him if he has a condom. And then let's just do this. And it happened. He was apparently so high that he had forgotten that he had sex with me in the first place.
Oh wow, that's fucked up.
I got a text message the next day being like, there's Carl's Jr. in my fridge. What did we do?
Oh my God.
I was just like, I can't do this. No. I need to find somebody else.
Yeah.
That really hurt.
Do you regret your decision at all, or are you like, you're good with it? The way it happened?
It wasn't my favorite experience, but I don't regret it. You know, I gave my consent. I went through it, and I was just like, okay, I understand what I want now.
Mm-hmm. For me, it was not completely consensual, so it wasn't really my choice. He was like, kind of threatening to like break up with me if I didn't.
Jeez,
I was just like, well, I love him so much and I don't want him to feel like I don't love him. Mm-hmm. And so I ended up doing it.
And to be honest, like, I don't remember much of the experience just because, like, I dissociated a lot. I was, like, trying to protect myself. But I don't regret it because I did my best with what I had. And, like, I don't think I could have changed anything because I vocalized, like, when I was uncomfortable and it just, he didn't really care. Mm-hmm. So, I definitely was not ready, but
that's fucked up.
I do have a better relationship with sex now. Mm-hmm. And I've made like a lot of progress too.
That's good. Yeah, that's
healing.
Thanks, right? Yeah.
Well, I wanted to say I'm sorry that happened to you. But everything does happen for a reason and it's a learning experience, so it only goes up from here.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. I do believe I learned a lot, but it feels weird to be like, that happened for a reason because, like,
that's what I'm saying.
In a way that would almost excuse his behavior. Yeah.
That's what I was saying. I was going to say, because she kind of, that kind of sounded a little bit condescending. She was like, everything happens for a reason. That's a learning experience. I'm just like, the fuck was I supposed to learn from that? That I didn't like it? Because, I feel like I know what she's trying to say, but then again, you don't say that to someone who had to go through something like that.
And I know, like, with, like, good intentions, like, everything does happen for a reason. I totally believe that, too.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I did learn a lot from it, and I don't think I'd be here, like, talking about it if it didn't happen. So
right.
I get, like, how the universe works, and like, it's just how it happened.
It
but,
just happened, yeah.
That's, like, not to say that what he did was okay.
Yeah, absolutely.
I was taught what consent looks like.
Oh, wow.
Okay, can I have all my disagreeers please come forward?
Funny seeing you guys all here.
Yeah,
love our society and school system.
In sex ed, we were taught how to put a condom on, what chlamydia is, what AIDS is. You're taught everything except you guys even want to do it, you know?
Yeah. That's a great point.
Okay, so I went to an all-girls private school, and then we were
What was the question? I was taught what consent looks like. So they were asked if anyone was taught what consent was, basically, and none of them agreed.
And with an all-boys private school as well. When I asked them what their sex ed was like, they were like, the teacher said, we know you're going to do it, so here's how you do it, here's how you put the condom on. And they told them everything. For us, it was taught by my PE teacher.
And that also sucks. What's up, Light? Welcome back. That also sucks that in most high schools, one of the most critical classes, sex ed, is always taught by like a substitute teacher, like a coach or something. And like that's a common thing to happen in American schools, that the sex ed teacher is always taught by someone who's not a sex ed teacher. And that is disgusting. And for any school to allow it to happen, because it's just like, now the teacher's being passive. They barely go over the curriculum. They pass people just for showing up. It's just like, no, you guys need to hire an actual teacher who teaches specifically sex ed, so these kids can understand how, like, the safety precautions, consent, results, like stuff that can happen from it. And it sucks. I took health ed for one semester in high school, and luckily for me, I had family members who were very who loved to talk to me about that kind of thing, and just to make sure that me becoming a woman was a more knowledgeable, easier transition. So all the women in my family were very adamant about making sure I knew what it was to be intimate with someone and to become a woman and stuff like that. And it's just like, I had to learn that outside of school. But like, yeah, my health / sex ed teacher was a fucking coach who did not care. Like, every day he would express how he would rather be coaching the wrestling team than being in there. And I'm just like, the principal does not want to put a teacher in here for real. You said, I honestly never took the class. I transferred schools in the middle of the course, and they said it was too late for me to join. Like, a class like this definitely needs to have an actual teacher who is invested in the curriculum, because it's just like, what are we trying to show these kids? You said my school didn't even have a sex ed class. My homeroom teacher played us a video, and that's it. Check my head. Yeah, that's so. The classes that I wish we had, except for like all these other classes that didn't make sense. I wish we had better sex ed classes, because high school is definitely the time when teenagers start to experiment and explore and learn about that kind of stuff. That's when teenagers start to do the do. So it's like, why not educate them on everything, like consent to like afterwards, like pregnancy and stuff. So it's like, I wish we had better sex ed courses. I wish we had more home economics. So like, there's not one school that I know. I learned it from my family. There's not one school that I know that teaches their students like how to pay bills, how to file taxes, how to do your finance. Exactly. They don't teach you about finances or anything, or how to budget, how to do any of this stuff. I had to learn that from like my uncles, because I literally like watch him do his taxes every year. And it's a difficult process. It's a very difficult process. So for them to not have those kinds of courses in school kind of sucks, because it's just like, we're going to have to do this stuff eventually, but y'all are giving us these classes that we only are going to care about for a year. How do you get credit? Right. How to build your credit, how to use a credit card, how to keep things good so you can buy a house, so you can pay your mortgage, how do you file taxes, how do you pay your bills, how do you do this and this, like there's no class on how to do that. Like, you just kind of have to learn it. And there's driving classes. I know schools that have driving classes. How do you, ducky? You stupid. I know there's some schools that implement driving courses into the school, but most driving courses are like, I took my driving class at Sears. That story. I don't think that story even exists anymore. That's crazy to say, but like, Sears was literally like an auto store. It was like a store slash. Sears is dead. Yeah, it's dead. Sears had a program for teens during the summer where they could sign up for driving course, and you would go there for like 4 weeks or something and take a driving class, and they'll give you your pass to go to the DMV and get your stuff done. I had to do mine online and at Sears, but I know of schools that implement driving courses at the school, and they use like the track field roads and like the parking lots for the students, and it's like a summer course as well. You went to the same driving school? Like, it's kind of ghetto too, because like either you go to a driving course or your parents teach you and you go to the DMV and it's good luck. What's up, you? Yuzo? What's up? I taught myself how to drive. I knew how to drive because my dad would always like let me drive his car, and my grandma would be like, get that baby out that stick shift car, she's gonna crash into something. And he would be like, mom, this my truck, so if my baby wanted to drive my truck, she'd drive my truck. But he will always be in the car with me. But I learned how to drive with him, but I didn't know like the technical shit. I didn't know like the road signs. I didn't know like intersections shit. I didn't know like the technical things about cars. I just knew how to actually drive. I knew how to parallel park. I always knew how to do that. I know when I went to go take my driver's test the first time, did I pass the first time? I did pass the first time, but I got a tick because the place that I went to was super strict. And the lady that was sitting in the car with me, she was like, you did everything right. You even did the hard part. You did the most difficult part, which was parallel parking. The only thing is that you did not signal when you backed up. So I'm going to tick you for that. And I barely made it. That one tick for not signaling while parallel parking was what almost made me not even get my learner's permit. You said my steering wheel was broken during my driver's test. Are you serious? You said, like, I went to college, but it's overrated. I wasn't learning anything new that I haven't learned already in high school. Damn. Yeah, it'd be like that. You went to actual driving school. There's a class I had called AVID that actually taught you about finances, and I hate myself to this day for not taking it seriously. Yeah, like, what I can say now is that there are, actually, I'm going to end up linking it in my Discord. If you look up, if you actually look up, there's free courses that Yale and Harvard open to the public online. You can take them for free, like business classes, finance, like basic finance classes, how to like, just like basic budgeting and basic like everything and everything you need to know in order to live your life or start a business. Yale and Harvard like actually release free classes. And I have the website because I've taken two of them. And they're actually pretty cool. They're pretty interesting. The classes like that can be found on YouTube as well. But if you want to feel like a pristine student that got accepted into an Ivy League school, you can take free courses from Yale and Harvard. You don't have to pay. You don't have to really. You can just sign up with your email and use their website. What's up, Zinni?
Okay. Right. And so then he was like, the best way to prevent pregnancy is to be abstinent. And I was like, that tells me nothing. What do you mean? And then they never talked about consent like within that either. And so when I reported my sexual assault incident, which wasn't the one that I described earlier, but I like did say no. And so I brought that up to their attention and they were just like, okay, but you stayed in the relationship after. So that basically means you're consenting to everything else. Mm-hmm. And I was like, that's not what that means. No, like even legally.
Yeah. That's so bad.
And so I know. And awesome. So then I went to my school counselor and she was like, I have a friend who's in a different police department. So I talked to that police officer and he was like, you could probably press charges against the first police department that you went to. But I was just like so over talking to different police officers. I was just like, this is too much. So I just left it at that. So I think what's wrong is the fact that no one can agree what consent looks like what the green lights are, what the red lights are, and just like even a yellow light, that should be stopped.
That makes a lot of sense.
That's really well said.
Yeah.
Thank you. I learned that whenever something happens, I kind of freeze. And I was...
That's another thing. People need to be taught what consent looks like. So when, even if your partner is like, yeah, I'm consent, and they're not acting like they're, you want, make sure you're asking the question so you don't feel like you've done, if you feel like you're doing something wrong, you're doing something wrong. So if you're with someone and they freeze up and they can't verbally say no, or they can't verbally, you got to start paying attention to body language. You got to start paying attention to someone's being silent. If they're quiet, they're probably uncomfortable. It's also your responsibility to ask, is this okay? Do you want this? Like, I'm getting into stuff, but it's on both parties to consent. But if one party can't consent, obviously if they're not sober to do it, don't do that. Like if they're not sober to consent, even if they say, yeah, don't do it because no. If they can't consent, don't do it.
I assaulted at one point. It was during a dance. Those dances, I do admit, they kind of turn into a grind fest.
Yeah. Yeah.
And, you know, that's all fun and everything like that. But then this one guy who I was with started getting very touchy with me. And it's very cramped.
Like,
I
will kick
you. I try to move, somebody pushes me back.
In the nose.
I can't, like, leave. So
drunk consent and consent.
First
thing
that happens to me is, like, my body sort of freezes.
Because sometimes no means no. All the time, no means no. But sometimes no means absolutely not. Just keep that in mind. All the time, no means no. Sometimes it means fucking no.
And it was kind of like a, should I let him keep going? Should I keep playing until I have an out? And my mind was kind of racing, but I was kind of frozen at the same time. Mm-hmm. And then finally, he took my hand, took me out of the crowd, and started walking towards the bathrooms. I just ran off and I went and found my friend group and I was just like, he thought I was consenting. That was definitely not it.
Yeah.
So it definitely was kind of hard to figure out the idea of consent at the time.
Yeah.
Wow. Sounds like he just assumed and that you should never assume someone has consent.
Yeah.
I'm really sorry that happened.
Yeah. And especially I was a sophomore at the time and I was definitely very much a virgin. So I was just like, no way in hell am I doing this right now.
Mm-hmm. Well, for me, for the longest time, consent means marriage. But I realized that that's not always the case because there could be assault in marriage. Like, if you don't want to do it, then you don't have to, you know, because it's your body, your choice. And just because you're married to that person doesn't mean you're obliged to, you know, follow through and do that with them. So I just have a vague idea of the whole subject because it's kind of like an untalked about topic in our religion. But just hopefully down the road, once we actually get to that point, then we're we gain more knowledge and education on it, so it could be a better experience for everyone.
I actually grew up in Minnesota in a town of 1,000 people, so you know, really awesome sex education, as you can assume.
So fun.
Of course. Honestly, it wasn't probably the worst, but since I'm asexual, I don't really have a sex drive either or whatever, so I was like,
that's so confusing.
I should try to figure out what this is. And so then with my first like boyfriend, we had been like dating. We met like first week of college and everything, and it was going all swell and everything. And then it was kind of getting to the point where you like assume would probably like, you know, start like kissing or like have sex and stuff like that. And I was starting to get really like anxious and nervous, like how am I gonna tell him not only that I'm a virgin, I guess I didn't really care that much since we are all like, you know, still young. But the idea of being like, I like don't want to really be physical with you really was eating at me. And the idea of having a conversation that's like intimate like that is always hard for anyone. And I didn't know how to bring it up to my partner at the time, and we were just like in his dorm room or whatever, and I just started like crying, and I was like, I don't like know how to tell you this, but like I like identify as asexual, and like if you don't
okay
want to be with me,
yo Jazzy, thank you for the 100 bits. I appreciate you and I love you, queen. Mwah. Thank you for that. Thank you.
Because I won't like have sex with you. Like I understand. Like I like felt broken, which is something that a lot of asexuals feel, but it's so not true. Like everyone is valid and everyone can be loved, and you don't have to have sex to be intimate with someone. And I just remember in that moment,
such
again. A low point, and just always growing in communication from there on out. And I hope no one ever has to feel like they have to feel like someone won't love them because they won't want to be physical with them or something.
How are you? So, I'm doing wonderful. How are
never
you doing?
Never entirely had to deal with that, only on a few occasions. One in particular, I was just picking up a lunch pail.
Okay, Zia, thank you for the 100 bits. I appreciate you, boy.
And the girl thank ahead you. Of us. And I texted her, like, hey, can you bring my friend's lunch pail over? And I knew she was into me just by the way she would look at me and she would try and talk to me. I'm like, okay. And then we just ended up hanging out in her car. And we're just talking. That's just how I am. I just like to talk with people. Totally cool with that. And then I started poking her, just joking around. That's just how I am, you know? She took my hand and she licked my finger.
Oh, okay.
And I was
like,
God.
Girl, she was ready. She was ready. I mean, low key, she's still in my moves. I mean, what? You said, girl, I'm tired. School kicking me a little. Oh, I understand. Yeah, I know. School is, but I'm glad that you're sticking at it. So get you some rest. Get you some rest. You got this, okay? You got this. What, Jazz? What? She said it tastes like candy, you know?
I was like,
COVID out there, be careful, right?
COVID.
What do you think we're doing right now? We're just chilling. Like we're just like right after, she straight up told me that she wanted me to her. Whoa. Legit like that. I was just like, I stopped looking at her. I sat in my chair. I was like, what? I was just like trying to process everything. Like I thought we were just vibing and we're just chilling.
What?
And that was a turn on, but then also a turn off. It was like, that wasn't my intent for you to come over. I just needed to bring my friend's lunch pail.
Yeah.
And you just want to get it on like that. Yeah. It made me feel a little weird around her because I thought we were like going to be friends. Mm-hmm. And then it was just straight shot somewhere else.
Yeah. I think it's interesting that if like a more femme person were to present the story, the like narrative would be totally different. And I think that's really interesting to consider, like if a guy like came onto a girl like that during like a lunch work thing, the circumstances would be so much different versus like we're kind of like laughing with you versus like.
No, I like that you said that because those kind of like biases pass us all the time. We never really realize them until someone brings it up, and you're absolutely right, because I totally would have changed the whole, like, the way I saw everything. I've been like, that's so scary.
It's just how it is for the male. If you're more, you know, masculine, they expect you to always want sex all the time, you know, but sometimes it's just not what you want to happen. And it's not really spoke about either when, like, you're a victim of, like, sexual assault as a man, or if you're more masculine. They're just going to be like, oh, well, what was wrong with that situation? Mm-hmm. So it's like, it's...
In that situation, like, my friends, in a joking way, they would think something's wrong with me.
Mm-hmm.
As in, like, why didn't you do it? Like, are you gay?
Yeah.
And that's so messed up.
Or they have seen it, sex, as kind of just, like, a fun activity. But I see it as so much more.
You value it more.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
So, like
you said, sometimes I just want to cuddle with a girl and watch One Piece. Exactly. I like sometimes, like, it's not about that. Like, I just want to order some pizza, get my hoodie, climb in bed, turn on the TV. Let's just cuddle and watch some animes. I can go to sleep. Please. I just want to go to bed. Man, I just want to close my eyes and knock out.
A good foundation first, where you guys have that trust and like that love embedded.
Exactly.
Where it makes sense.
If we're going to be doing this together, I have to feel like we're both in this together.
Yeah.
And like it goes even further than just that moment.
Yeah.
Sleep. Exactly. Right. Yeah.
It's not physical. It's like your soul connection, you know?
Exactly.
Your souls connect and you will connect forever.
Like if you can't sit in silence or sit and watch anime with me or watch any kind of show with me, it's like, get out. Get out, because I don't want the second you hear the Netflix ba-doom, and he's like, oh, take off your pants. No, like, no. No, mm-mm. I want to watch. Like, I'm invested in this show. This is my shit. So if I miss any part of this episode, I'm going to be pissed off. So, but you can rewind. I don't want to. One and done. I don't want to. If you can't put your phone down and watch something for like an hour, yeah, get it right. Oh my God, people that can't put their phone down irritates me. Because I know that we're all stuck on our phones, but it's like, when I'm with someone, it's just like, I like to put my phone down. Even if there's stuff going on, I'll check it, but like I'll put my phone down. And a lot of times I just turn it over, so I don't even see like notifications. Because it's just like, be in the moment. Be right here. In the moment. There's time for Netflix and chill, and there's time for Netflix. I couldn't have thought of a more perfect statement. He said, I told this one girl I'd take her out for lunch, dinner. She think I want to smash, but nah, I just want to rekindle our friendship. Like, short, I just want to catch up with you. Nothing more, right? Right. She probably got the wrong message. You ask a girl out to dinner and you ask a girl out, I'd be like, this is not a date, you know, I just wanna, we ain't talked in a long time. Let's grab something to eat as friends. And then, but like if it's a date, then she'd be like, hey, I wanna take you out. Be ready, dress up nice, I'll pick you up. That's a date. But yeah. If you don't clarify, sometimes they think it's a date and you're just like, fuck. What if I say it's not, they get mad and they clown on you? Clown me all you want. If I don't want to take you on a date, I don't want to take you on a date. She still would have misunderstood. Right, unless you physically say, by the way, this is not, caps, underscore, underline, this is not a date. We just haven't talked in a long time and I just want to catch up, see how you're doing in life. After that, I'm probably going to leave and slide in this girl's DMs I've been looking at for 3 weeks. How would you ask for a date? You'd be like, hey, this is how I would see a date. Like, hey, I kind of want to get to know you better. You know, you're attractive. I would like to get to know you. If you would like to get to know me some more, let's go out to dinner. Let me take you out. Let me treat you. Wear something nice. I'll come and get you. I'll pick you up. My treat. That's legit. I was laughing at myself. I'm sorry. I saw that.
Absolutely. Yes.
Yeah.
I think it's also important to note that not everyone agrees that it's a soul connection, and just opening the conversation people have different perceptions of it too. So
absolutely.
I think that's important to note, and that's why there can also be like not equivalent forms of consent too. If someone like thinks of sex as something that's super important and spiritual and all that, but someone else is like, oh, it's just like exercising or something.
You said, now she thinks I'm crush on her. She said it would be weird to be friends if I'm crushing when I just got out of a relationship. I'm chilling, but she hasn't texted me back. Really? No free food for her. So y'all haven't talked ever since? If I ever get turned down, send that bitch to the back rooms. I'm sorry, what? You're sending her to the back rooms? That is that is so evil. That is so evil.
We put too much importance on virginity.
Yeah, I think there is too much of an importance on it. I think it's made out to be, it's just gonna be amazing, and this is how it's gonna be. Everyone like talks it up, everyone talks a big game about it, and sometimes it can be. I've had friends who say they're like gonna wait for marriage, and they do. And then they tell me like, that was it? Like, that's what all the hype was about? And so then they're just like, they've gone like their whole lives identifying with this one thing.
Oh, that's a good question. That's a good question. You said, can your boyfriend comment on female acquaintance and a female acquaintance post, especially if he had proven his commitment towards you? Personally, for me, in a relationship, I do not. It's a trust thing. If you trust your partner, you guys have established y'all's relationship, and you trust each other, then like stuff like social media posts aren't a bother, unless it's something like visually like concerning, like, you know, a bunch of like eggplant emojis and all that stuff, and that makes you uncomfortable and you brought it up to them and they're still doing it and stuff like that, then yeah, no, that's a red flag. That's obviously not okay. But then like following other women or liking their posts and stuff or like commenting, it's not like something that I would freak out about at all. It's not like, oh my gosh, why did you like her post? Or why do you follow so and so and so? Like that's like, no. Like if I'm able to follow guys and like their posts and comment as well, and there be like absolutely nothing there, then like it's 100% fine. Subway Surfer, really? You making me want to play that.
That they've never even really experienced, and then it's just like shattered. And they've taken on this identity for so long, then they like, I don't know who I am. And like that's something a lot of my friends have struggled with. I feel like there's not enough conversation about how you feel after the fact if you are previously really tied to the concept of being a virgin.
So I'm like 50-50 on this. It should be importance on it, just for the fact that if you do slip and mess up, you can have a kid. And I guess that's a big thing for me, is why I'm still a virgin, is that I'm not ready for kids yet. Mm-hmm. And also with virginity.
They the one?
Since, like, all the way to elementary school, I've heard girls losing their virginity, which is crazy for me to think. The joking adds to it. Like, we all joke around with topics and stuff, but it just adds to the importance that we view it, so. Mm-hmm.
I hear what you're saying about, like, we maybe need to have the idea, like the word virgin or virginity, to have conversations about it. But when you think about it, there's so many things in life that we don't have like a label or a word for. Like, even just thinking about like, oh, like having kissed someone, it's not like, oh, like, yeah, let's come up with a word for someone who's kissed someone. Like, I'm a sex haver, I'm a kiss haver. Yeah. Like, it's like even thinking about the idea of virginity, I think the importance that's put on it is like very toxic, because it is talking about like usually the idea of like penis in vagina sex. And it's like, yeah, like that sounds like really like stupid to say, like, but it's true. Is like, yeah, what people's like, I'd say mainstream notion of what is virginity. And it's like making this like pedestal of purity, right, and this heteronormative experience of what is virginity. And I just think it's, yeah, outdated and should be eradicated.
Right. I think it very much like pushes forward the idea of purity culture. Because if you also look at the definition of virgin, it comes from sexually intact woman. And that's implying that it only happens to women, only women can be virgins. And that's, we know that's not true, I mean, yeah. Right? I take issue with the fact that it also says sexually intact, like as if you lose something and you're all of a sudden destroyed. And
that's one thing that I was talking about, like the importance of virginity is, it's important, especially if you're not educated on what sex is and the consequences of that, of what can happen if you're not careful or safe. But like the notion that like if you've had sex that and you're destroyed and you're like damaged goods and you're like not suitable to be married or be in a relationship because you have a body count, whatever. I think that's probably the stupidest thing ever, because it makes it seem like virginity is something that you take from someone, and the person who holds that has like power or has like some kind of say over you because you gave it to them. It's like, nobody, no, that's not how this works. No. I think that's like the, I think that part of like virginity or whatever is outdated. Like, not being a virgin makes you impure or makes you not like damaged goods or something. That's what's messed up to me.
Like, you don't lose anything, and like, right, it's still like a great experience for both partners, hopefully. It's weird that we felt a need to put,
you said a question, do y'all think sex should be had at least once with your partner before you marry them? Honestly, for me, it's a religion thing for a lot of people. I know most religions, or many religions, require that you don't have sex until marriage, because of your religion, and that's 100% fair. 100% fair. For anyone who doesn't believe or have a belief that involves that, I would say it's not a problem to me. But of course, it's different for everybody, because some people want to only have sex under that marital standard, and which is fine. That's like 100% fine. There's also the fear that, you know, once you get married, now you're married to this person, you're committed to them, and then you finally have sex, and then you're just like, oh, well, you're bad in bed. Like, I don't like it, you're bad in bed. But then that also goes to show, like, do you have an emotional connection with that person? Do you have a mental connection with that person? And if it's not great physically, do y'all make up for it in other areas and stuff like that? But, like, some people definitely get married, and after marriage they find out that, you know, their partner isn't great in bed, and they're just like, oh, well, I waited all my life to get married for this. And that is not the motive that you want to have when getting married, is just so you can lose your virginity, because you will be disappointed sometimes. For me, I am not the person that has to be married. I used to want to be. I was like, I mean, I'm still a virgin, so it didn't apply to me. But if I weren't, I would definitely say that getting married is not a requirement for me. Yeah. But I do respect everyone who does. I literally know a guy who has over 100 bodies before you graduate high school, only because he looked like Odell Beckham. Oh, I did not mean to laugh. I didn't laugh. I snickered. Oh, that's hilarious. So I think marriage before pregnancy should be a thing for sure. Personally, I do agree. I don't want to have children with anyone that I'm not married to. That, I want to do that correctly, which is why also having sex before marriage for me will also mean that I would have to be careful, or we would have to be careful. We would have to both understand that we're not trying to have children. But like, I personally don't want to have children with anyone outside of marriage. That's just me personally. But, you know, everyone's different. You said just asking because generally folks believe sex is important in a relationship. But if you wait until after marriage and it's trash, then what? Some folks just cheat at that point, which is trash. I also agree that waiting until marriage to have sex can be difficult. Whenever you do have sex and you guys find out that you aren't sexually compatible, that can make or break a lot of relationships, because you know, humans are very sexual beings, and for the most part. So if you guys aren't feeling in bed and, you know, it just crumbles from there, now you got, now you're irritated in your marriage because you guys don't, aren't attracted to each other sexually. But like I said, everyone's different. I personally do not care about waiting until marriage to have sex, but I do care about waiting until marriage to have a child. So, and dog, all the bodies or whom you have sex with in high school ain't gonna matter in the real world. So flexing on having sex young is kind of redundant. It is. You said, I relate a lot with that personally. What's up, Raina? I've done a lot of mental back and forth before debating on how I wanted to handle my first. Yeah, and honestly, all I can say about me personally is that the first time for me is just something that I want at that time with who I want it to be with. And for me, all I can say is I'm perfectly happy with the decisions that I've made. But as far as, you know, starting a family, family-wise, starting a family, I definitely want to wait until I build a foundation, because that requires the commitment of both parties. And sex can be very casual, because if you both are careful, it doesn't really come with consequences unless you consider emotional ties a consequence. But like, if both parties are careful, you don't really worry about the consequences of sex. But like, starting a family, that's like something that both of you have to be invested in, because you brought a third party into the situation. You brought a third party into it. Now there's another being. So that personally for me is where I want to be married. Absolutely. Because then I know that I want to start a family with this person. I love this conversation, bless you guys. It's low-key important, not talked about enough. And I wish it was, especially to younger people, because like, that younger people, especially in high school, is when people start making very life-changing decisions. I feel like people who overemphasize marriage and see it as a form of validating their love instead of the inverse. Like, when people think that someone will start acting right once they're married. I hate that. And I hate the conversation of when men see women and vice versa, and they're just like, you act like this, how are you ever gonna get married? How you gonna get married? I hate that so much. Sex brings attachment. Yeah, sex to me, sex is an exchange of energy. It's a very big exchange of energy, so it's a very big deal between people. And for me personally, so I personally am not a person that will have sex with someone who I don't already have a connection with. If you have casual sex, that's fine. That's you. I personally cannot be physical with someone that I do not have some kind of connection to. Like, for me, that does not work, because I am a very emotional person that I do get attached to people. So I'm very careful about who I share that part of myself with. You say, if it happens, it happens, though. I don't think one should date with the sole purpose of having sex. Exactly. Because if you're only dating someone and the end result being having sex and that's it, you're going to be mad disappointed. Mad disappointed. Man up. Stand up. Stand up. But then again, for if it's a part of your religion, I 100% respect that shit. 100%. 1,000%. Because I get it. But what I don't like is like when you do get married and you do have sex, and now it's like this person expects you to have sex with them 24/7. No, that's not how that works. You can still consent. Trina, give me your blanket. No, it's mine. It's mine. 100% mine. You cannot have it. You cannot take this from me. But you said, Nicole, would you ever in your life be on Married at First Sight? Because I think it looks kind of fun. That reality show, Married at First Sight? Hell no. fuck no at that, because no, 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 I can't. I can't. The way that I am, I cannot. I cannot. I cannot marry anyone at first sight. Just marrying someone because of what they physically look like sucks. Good luck, because beauty is fleeting and attraction only goes so far. Like, physical attraction only goes so far. You said that 24/7 sex shit is while having sex and you're not in the mood is not it, right? You can still assault a person that you're married to. You can still do that. So that's why I never saw it that way. You said, when I heard have sex and to be disappointed, I fucking got looked over at and hit the wall. So what the fuck, Zia? Gonna fuck around and get married at first sight. Aya, invite me to your wedding. Good luck. I'll bring tissues. I hate people who have sex just to have sex and leave. Like, what? Yeah. I mean, I don't hate y'all, but it's like everyone's different. If you can have sex with someone and not be emotionally attached to them, that's you. You got it. You can handle that mentally. You got it. Me, I cannot. I cannot. I be in love. I be in love. I be in love. People be having sex. That's wild. Right. Goofy, what is that? What the fuck is sex? That's real? I thought y'all was lying about that shit. I didn't know that was real. Y'all fucking lying. You said, I couldn't do that, man. Too much commitment without knowing a thing about the other person. Exactly. You said, all I know is that if what goes in my life goes down as planned and this shit is over hype, I'm gonna be upset. Let me tell you something. People, I be humping my bed like a motherfucking goofy. What? Proof. Or didn't have. I'm kidding. Here's the thing. A lot of people like to hype sex up, especially in this day and age, because porn is a very huge part of this culture because of the internet. Do not let that fool you. Do not let that fool you. You said it's overhyped. Without any kind of other connection, yes, absolutely. 100%. 100%. You just losing it to someone that you have no other connection to. 100% overhyped. 100%. More than 100%. If I cannot stress that enough, I cannot stress that enough. When you have found that you have more than physical attraction to someone, and you guys have connected on a spiritual level, a mental level, an emotional level, that's when I will overhype the sex, because it's just like, damn, we connected for real. Like, we like this. And that's where I personally am just like, okay, yeah, yes, yes. This is something that I want to do because I know that I'm attached to you in this sort of way. So. Other than that, me personally, I will not do it. I will not. That's not right. You said they be trying to fill a void and they saw it, and that's why I be hitting. Yup. People definitely like to fill a void, and that sucks, because you're filling a void. You don't know how it is for that other person. That person is falling in love with you and you are having sex and you're just like, ah. Well, I got what I needed for tonight. See ya. Peace. Bye. I can't tell you how, one, heartbreaking that is, but how annoying and how draining that is for someone to have all of their energy drained like that. I can tell you from experience, Goofy, I can too. So it's like when someone like drains you like that, it's a lot. Because sex is a very huge exchange of energy between people. So... Franny said, porn is fucking fake. Some of that is not even consensual. Be careful about these porno fantasies or whatever people. That's another thing. Porn is acting. It's acting. And when it's not, it ain't real. It still ain't real. So, one, be careful about what you're coming across. Two, do not expect real life to be that. I think most people know that by now. But if you don't, then yes, do not use porn as an example. and don't use it as where you're learning about sex. It's not a good example to learn about sex. What's up, Erie? What's up, Queen? How you doing? How are you doing? But yeah, I personally say if it's in your religion and that's something that you're very strong about, is waiting until marriage to have sex. Absolutely, absolutely. Me personally, I have a different belief, so I respect you for that. Me personally, it's not a religious thing. I do prefer to be married, but it's not a religious thing for me, and it's not something that I would hate myself for. But as far as having a family, yes, I want to be married 100%. Having kids is something that I 100% want to be married before that happens. So you said I'm good. How about your fine? So I'm good. Thank you. I hope you're having a great time. We were talking about crumble cookies earlier while I was playing Backrooms.
Put a label on that part of women who are sexually intact as opposed to someone bi.
Word things so perfectly. Right. Yeah, hard for me to speak.
Wait, you said I don't want no kids no more. I'm trying to be the fun uncle who travels. Right now, that is what I am. I am living my best life as the fun aunt who has snacks in her purse for the kiddos and can play with the children and then give them back to their parental unit when I'm done. I'm perfectly fine with that. Being able to play with the little babies. Oh, you're so cute. You're a baby. Now go back to your parental unit. That's right, because I'm not. Now, when the time is right and I get married. Oh, I'm having five kids. I'm having five. At the moment, no. No. You said edibles on deck? That's crazy. Five, yes, I want a big family. Five, y'all are shocked that I said five. Listen, I'm having as many as the Lord will bless me with. And if it's five, it's five. Nah, three. Realistically, three at the most. I want my kids to have siblings. I want my kids to have siblings. I don't want to have a kid like and have them be alone. She said seven like an hour ago. Yeah, y'all weren't here a little while ago. I actually said nine. But however many I'm blessed with is how many I'ma have. Nicole gonna be in love for. If y'all ever see me with a kid, just know that I am in love. And that's why I said, I was telling y'all earlier, I'm not gonna tell nobody shit. Like, y'all gonna see me one day, I'm gonna be like, what's up, y'all? The next day, y'all gonna see me, y'all, this is my baby. Y'all gonna be like, what? I'm not saying nothing. I'm like, oh yeah, I'm married, by the way. It's my ring. Yeah, I got married like 2 years ago. Oh yeah, this is my kid. She's like 3 months old. I'm not saying nothing when it happens. I'm not finna have y'all have a Rihanna moment with me. We realized the bump. Oh no, y'all not gonna see the bump because I will not be standing up on stream. You said I feel like Nicole gonna have a superfood fetish while pregnant. The pickles. Hey, I have that right now. Oh my god, I'm so embarrassed. Y'all wanna know something? All right, so boom. Okay, so I obviously I don't have kids, so I've never been pregnant. However, When us ladies be on our circle, we get the same symptoms, just without the baby. So sometimes when I'm on my, sometimes when I have a circle, I'll be having cravings. Yes, I have a circle. Y'all know what I'm talking about. When us ladies be on our circles, we get hungry. You guys, my friends, I know for a fact, me personally, I'm gonna start calling it a circle. Yes, this okay. I'm gonna show y'all how it looks when I text it out to people of the opposite gender whenever I'm having a circle. This is what it looks like. That's what I text. TMI, but that's what I had asked me, and I was like, yo, why? He was like, yo, you seem so irritated. And I just texted him the circle. So us ladies, when we be on our circle, I know for a fact, I know when it's about to happen because I get hungry and I have to, physically stop myself from going in the kitchen. I will act like I'm a Sim that just got their action canceled because it's like, I go in the kitchen. You sound blocking you if you do that. I don't tell it to my lady friends. I don't tell it to my lady friends, usually the guys. And I'm gonna start putting it on Twitter just so y'all know as well. On Twitter, sometimes I'll be wanting to tweet about what I'm be going through, but I don't want to be too much TMI. So if y'all ever see that red circle, I'm gonna end the tweet with that red circle so y'all know what's going on. So anytime I say something and I seem irritated, I'm gonna just put the red circle. Yeah, then y'all will understand. But normally I know it's about to happen because I get PMS. I'm sending you to the back rooms. I personally get PMS. So, but I'm very good at like handling it. Like usually I isolate myself. I just stay in my room by myself. But a lot of times I know that I get quick tempered, but I don't act on it. So I just get super quiet. But the smallest things irritate me. Like I was playing Grand Theft Auto and I was playing blackjack and the woman got 21. I said, you fucking bitch. And like, usually blackjack don't piss me off. If she get a 21, I'd be like, oh, you lucky bitch. But like that time I was like, you fucking, like I was ready to like burn the game physically. And it's digital. So that's how I knew right then and there that I was red circle. And the cravings are nuts because the concoction that I came up with one time, let me tell y'all what happened. I was hungry. Pickles and peanut butter do hit, but this is what happened. Went to the kitchen and I didn't grocery shop yet. So I didn't have much to work with to begin with. So hear me out. I made my own personal Big Mac. And as you know, I am pescatarian. So I had some fish, heated that shit up. I put the fish, I got some fish, refried it, right? Toasted some bread, got some Munster cheese, put mustard on that. I put lettuce. I put a little bit of vinegar dressing on it. Oh my god. And then another slice of cheese, and then I broke up the fish, so then there was another piece of cheese. Munster, M-U-E, or is it M-E-U? Munster. It's like German. It's so fucking good. And I just layered that shit. I layered it on the side. I put a dot of ketchup, a dot of jelly, and I had sour cream, Lay's potato chips. Went back to my room and I went to fucking town. After that, I had some ice cream. And the ice cream that I had was Rocky Road, which is not something that I normally eat. A circle of ketchup? Yes, a circle. It was a dot of ketchup and a dot of jelly, like sweet jelly. The red circle would be Twitter canon. I feel like I'm the only person that used that circle too. So I'm gonna start a movement. You ever see another circle? That's what they're talking about. And I started that. But yes, I know that the stuff that I be going through right now, when the day that I have a tummy bump, is gonna be like 10 times what I've gone through already. So I don't know if I should be scared or not. I mean, I shouldn't be scared because it's not happening anytime soon. However, when it does, I'm so sorry to anyone that will be friends with me during that time. So this is a verbal apology in advance. Yeah. Yo, Goofy, you gonna be a great dad one day. Yo, you gonna be a great you gonna be a great dad. I'm gonna be an outstanding mom. My kids will love me. You think so? Absolutely. Absolutely. Absolutely, Goof. I see that for you 100,000%. If that is what you want someday, I feel like you're gonna change your mind. I'm gonna be big, goofy, sensitive. Exactly. You're gonna have the you're gonna be like a big, like, strong dude, and then have a soft spot for your kids. And that's gonna be like the cutest day ever. Yeah, right. His kids gonna call him Pops. Yes, his kids gonna call him Pops when they turn teenagers, and now they old enough for Goofy to punch him in the chest when they start acting up. He gonna come with a basketball. What's up, Pops? I see it for him. Goofy, yo, go ahead and have the little babies. Go ahead and have him. Go ahead and have him. He gonna give him the Goofy cut. That's why I call it his little Goofy cut. That's gonna be adorable. Yes. I don't know if I should be offended. No, that's a compliment. Oh my God! Listen, yo, if you have a daughter, I volunteer to babysit, but like also make her middle name Nicole. That would be adorable. Yes. All right, get to work, Goofy. Get to work. I can hook you up with somebody right now. My daughter gonna be big as fuck. She gonna be cool. She gonna be cool as hell. Get to work. Get started. She's going to come out your height. Right? I'm tall as hell. Yo. That means your daughter's going to be tall. That means your daughter's going to be tall. Like, mad tall. Get her into some gymnastics. Get into some kind of dance. Some kind of art. She's going to be creative. Your kid's going to be creative just like you. Oh, my God. You love to see it. I think I'll be a cool mom. My. I'm a raise my kids to be happy children. All right, they're gonna be happy. If Goofy child comes to be taller than him, I will be concerned. You said fuck sports, yeah. Hey, that's another thing. Just because you're tall doesn't mean you have to play sports. You don't have to play sports. You said, in the words of PG, Nicole is a tall glass of water. You want me to prove it? I can prove it. Like, oh my God. I am a tall glass of water. Look at me. Like, it doesn't get any better than this. Like, do you see me? I'm a dime piece. I am a dime piece. I'm a tall glass of water. Oh my God. I'm a tall glass of milk. Like, the girls just aren't doing it the way that I do it. Seize the chair. I'm not standing on my chair. I'm standing in front of it. Bench. No one told you to look at my chair. Don't do that. It's not right. 10 out of 10. Thank you. Nicole so fly. Thanks. Thank you. I appreciate that. W mom, now what if I told you that I'm wearing this hoodie for a reason? It's just to cover up. I didn't feel like it was time to announce that. Okay, I'll just make the announcement now because there's a reason why the hoodie sent me a hoodie. All right, it's time that you know. I ate good today, yo. I had a good lunch. I had a lot to eat, and I feel like this hoodie is very good in keeping me warm. I'm finna hibernate. No, I'm not with child. I just ate good today. Thank you for your well wishes. Please bear with me. I just want to appreciate everyone who sent me messages saying congratulations. That sandwich that I made today was bomb.
I feel like I'm word vomiting. So
no, it's perfect. I love it.
I think for me, when I don't know, just the environment that I grew up in, with how high school was, I felt like it was kind of like
you said. Slot the link for the hoodie, yo! Exclamation point, hoodie. This is called the hoodie. By the way, here. That's what you get. The hoodie was nice enough to send me this nice. It's very comfortable. Go ahead and use that discount code, TheNicoleB, for 30% off of your first hoodie. Except if you're Norwegian, if you're in Norway, you can't get that for 30% off. But however, if you're in the Americas or surrounding countries, You can purchase this hoodie for 30% off. Yes, petty. I'm not being petty. I'm just saying, everyone who live in nowhere, I'm sorry. Hoodie real drip. Right, you heard of a snuggle, a snuggie. Snuggies ain't doing it like the hoodie is. It's got, not only, hold on, let me model for y'all. Let me advertise this right. Let me do this right. They comfy as fuck. Hold on. I got you. Now. Stroll down the runway. Another payday. Okay. Cover of all right. Magazine. Today I will be modeling for you the hoodie. Hold on, I got you. Cover girl, put the bass in your- Hold on, no, that's not the one that I wanted. There we go.
Once upon a time.
All right. There was a little black Y'all asked for it, so this is what you're going to get.
Of Detroit,
Here we go.
At 15.
And I'm going to bogey for you too, baby. I'm going to bogey for you too, because after this... And her mom. You gonna want one. This is the hoodie, 70% off using code TheNicoleB. Get yours. Has a little hoodie. Best part of this hoodie. Go ahead and copy one. That's me going down the runway. Free movement if you're trying to twerk. Yes, or if you're trying to ballroom dance. Or if you're trying to shuffle, you at a rave. There's so much movement you can do in it. As fly as me on the runway, go ahead and copy an hoodie. Code is TheNicoleB. Get 30% off your first hoodie. Thank you very much. Yes. Can I wear it while you're showering? If you want to. Look fly. Where's the link? Baby, that is !! Hoodie. !! It will drop the link for the website. I also give you my discount code. Run it up. Tell them Nicole sent you. There it is. Thank you, Alia. Thank you very much.
Like, if you're a non-virgin, you're one of us. If you're still a virgin, it's just like, we kind of forget that you exist. So that was sort of like, my perspective on that.
I totally forgot we were watching this. Y'all gotta stop distracting me. I got ADHD. I have no clue what's going on no more.
Yeah, I was listening. I was like, wow, that's really cool how you guys like think about that. For me personally,
you did ask me to cut one. Hey, you cut one. I better see a photo of you in it.
Personally, I think there is a huge importance on keeping your virginity. It's not more like you're virgin or you're not. It's how you lose your virginity. And
TKO,
how
you should, thank you for the follow. I appreciate
it. We're supposed to lose our virginity is by being married.
Sex.
And, nice. So for myself, like, I hold the same expectation for my future spouse. that because the same regulations apply to him, you know? He had to stay a virgin until marriage. And actually, in our religion, like, doing anything intimate, getting close to anything that goes without meaning, like hand-holding or just like kissing or anything, all of those are strongly prohibited, and it's because it's all a sin. If I fall in love with a person or they come into my life and they're not a virgin, then it would be okay if they understand that that was a sin and they ask for forgiveness. It's how it works, basically.
I never knew all that. I guess this is just like an open-ended question. Mm-hmm. How have your perceptions of virginity changed from when you were younger to where you are now? Like, is there any difference, something new you learned?
Yeah, mine definitely has changed.
You said all of those, they're going to suck at sex when they start. Goofy, I'm going to beat your ass. Come here. You getting a slap on the wrist. Shut your mouth. Stop it. Stop. These people done already did it, though. These people, this side over here, they done did it already. The side with the woman in the yellow, they're virgins. What's up, Angela? That's right. You said, damn, you can't kiss without going to hell? Shit, I'm burning. Hey, to me, all this shit is made up.
For sure.
And I remember, like, hi, around Angela. The time where...
Can I ask a serious question? Ask away.
You know, I was ask debating away, about gotcha. Losing my virginity and stuff like that. I kind of ran into some people, you know, when I was online dating. Like, as soon as I tell them, it's almost like they're kind of fetishizing me in a way where it's just like, you're a virgin, I'm ready to take that. And it's just like, they're just trying to figure out, like, as soon as I have one date with them, they're just like trying to get it in. I'm just like,
grandma, thank you for the follow, I appreciate you.
No, stay away, 6 feet apart.
You said, Goofy, we was just talking about this. We was just talking about this. Like, what if you get married, even from a religious point of view, what if you get married and after that you saved, you waited all this time. You waited all this time just to lose it to someone that and they're horrible in bed. Which is why I'm an atheist. Happy Black History Month. No, I'm kidding. I personally, that's why I said marriage for me is not a requirement. I used to want to save myself for marriage, but no, that's not happening. No. I'm saving myself for a family though, for children. However, when it comes to sex, then no, that's not a requirement for me because it's just like, because now I got a ring on my finger and you suck. No. Then again, you know, for some people, sex is a make it or break it in the relationship, and for other people, it's not. So people that do wait to get married, and then they lose their virginity and the sex isn't great, they still stay with them because they have an emotional connection, a mental connection, and they're fine with that. So you said, what if you like DJ Khaled and he don't eat? then again, everyone always has an opportunity to learn. So even if you're not sexually compatible and you talk to your partner and be like, hey, I like this, or let's try this, and maybe y'all can learn together what y'all like, and that could be A1, that could be fire. You know, maybe y'all aren't compatible right away, but y'all learn about what each other likes. Because not everyone's going to get it right the first time, especially if you're a virgin. But, like, maybe you're not compatible. And maybe you're both open to having the conversation that, hey, okay, so let's try something new. Let's try something different in bed. And then y'all become compatible. And that, hey. I can't. You said, right, encourage your partner. Sometimes you got to be patient. Right. Maybe it's not compatible right away, but you could be at some point. It's all depending on if that's okay with you or not. Because, you know, maybe you're the one that sucks and you don't know it. Growth, right? Growth. To me, that's kind of cool. Because maybe we didn't start off too great, but, like, then you started to learn about me. And I started to learn about you. And now, she's wild. Shit, nasty. No, let me stop. What's up, Pablo? How you doing? He said, I feel you like a mortgage on a house. Yeah. And then, but then to me personally, that's also like playing dice. You know? To me, it's a big part of the relationship. However, it's not mandatory. So, if you want to take that chance, you want to take that chance. However, I like to be kind of certain before I marry somebody, which is why we gonna move in together, okay? We gonna do what needs to be done, okay? And then we can get married. And then we can have a family. So girls like guys are experienced because they know which. Hey, shut your crack ass mouth. Shut your mouth. You gotta know when to jump ship. Yeah. All I'm saying is that, yeah, for some reason, girls always want someone who's already experienced. And, you know, so do some guys. Guys just be like, I want a virgin, but I don't want someone who doesn't know what she's doing and stuff like that. And she don't know how to do this, this, and this. But you wanted a virgin. So, like, what did you want? Crackass. Yo, Angel, I've stolen your vocabulary. I've been saying that to Ari lately. She gonna see that schlong. What the fuck? Hey, that's not right. Shut your crack ass mouth. W theft. Angela, you are a pioneer for most vocabulary. I want you to know that. So as a person who comes from a strong religious standpoint, I have now understood for myself. I agree with the fundamentals for it, but have also let the rule go. I personally believe that if you stand on that, don't let me sway you from your religion. If that's something that you follow and that's how you live your life, then that's how you live your life. And that is also very valid. For you, that's perfectly fine. That's perfect. Waiting until marriage is perfectly fine. So I've been thinking on this for years. Yeah, it took me a while to make the decision. I didn't want to be influenced by my friends or by social media or by any kind of media about how I should feel about losing my virginity or having sex. I wanted to make that decision for myself. So if we're not married first, then we're just not married first. And but we're together. That's what we want in the moment. And we're careful about it. We're doing something that we both consent to and both understand the risks of what comes with that. So yeah, that's how I see it. But for anyone who's following it religiously, do not change your views simply because I said something. So you're taking a piece of me wherever you go when you say that. Honestly, Angela, I take you everywhere I go. It's like I want you to be in my pocket. You see this pocket right here? I want you to literally get into my pocket so I can take you everywhere I go. You say guys lose their virginity recklessly, templessly. I'm guys. Yeah, literally, and it's a lot of how men are raised. That's why I've seen it a lot in a lot of households. You know, parents are more strict on the girls, and guys are just like, they may get in trouble, but it's just like, your men will be men, boys will be boys, but girls won't be girls because, you know, we get stricter punishments, we get stricter, like, parents are just stricter with girls. Thank you so much for the resub for 4 months, Kev. I miss you, bro. I hope you're having a good night, and I hope you're staying warm in this fucking cold ass shit. You said guys treat losing their V card like a Xbox achievement. Exactly. They just got a fucking badge because you have a womb. Yes. We can physically get pregnant. But you know, we wouldn't be able to if the guy didn't do it. If it's a two-party thing. Yes, we can get pregnant, but guys got to do the act too. Guys, we both got to do the act. So you're just as responsible. You're just not having it. You're just not pushing it out of you. But both are responsible, however. You said tree girls, right? So you have a son instead of a daughter. That doesn't make sense. You can't customize this shit. This ain't The Sims. But you want to educate guys as much as you educate girls, because even though we're the ones that are getting pregnant, the guys, you know, it's a two-person tango. So y'all got the sauce, we just got the bowl. No amount of money would get me to say that again, but it's true. It's facts though. I'm being dead ass. I'm being dead ass about that. So without one or the other, you know, we can't handle, we can't, you know, I'm just saying. But am I wrong? So I think it's equally important for both to know what's going on. So yes, I will be on my son's ass just as much as I'll be on my daughter's ass. Like, no, you can't just go out here and slang it because you want to. And no, you can't just go out here and do it because you want to. Just like, y'all need to understand what's going to happen to the both of y'all. Nicole, are you wearing a child size hoodie or a regular? I'm an adult. What are you trying to say, man? You said I'm asking for me. Oh. Sorry, I pulled a Kirby. It's like, you made me like beat my desk. This is an adult size. but you're smaller than me. No, get this size. No. Trust me. Get the regular adult size. Get this size. It's usually one size fit all. But get this size. She's 6'4", y'all. Damn, exactly. Thank you. I'm an adult. I am a grown. It's child. Shut your crack ass mouth. I am a grown. Thank you. I got you. Yes, I got the grown people one. I got the grown up, the grown folks. Thanks. I don't know which design to get. There's so many designs. They're so cute. They're all very cute. There's bundles too. It's not just these. They got socks. You an adult? Yes, I'm a grown. More like a grown ass child. That's an oxymoron. That is an oxymoron, and I am not fat. You said I'm 5'11". I'm not that much shorter than you. Yeah. You're a little bit shorter than me, but not that much. So, do you date shorter guys, Nicole? Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. I don't often date, but I've definitely liked guys that weren't as tall as me. Or we were like the same height, or he was like half an inch shorter than me. Can I get a transparent? Oh yeah, you are a menace. If they make one, they're not giving it to you. But I would like to see it. They need to let me make my own. I was saying that. That they need to make hoodies like customizable. Like, you can put your own designs on there. You date taller guys? I date any guy that I like. Like, I don't care if you all the way up here or you right here to me. And I can pick you up. I mean, I prefer to be picked up because I'm the baby. However, if I like you, I like you. I know everyone has their preferences, but I have a history of not liking the same type of person. No, that's not true, because all of them have all hurt my feelings. But like in physical appearance, there's no consecutive like. they all look different. Of all ethnicities, of all sizes, of different weights, the only thing that they all have in common is that they all hurt my feelings. That's the only thing they all have in common, is that they all hurt my feelings. So, people really be dating. I can't, right? Like, how is that so easy for y'all? Y'all just be going outside and like going on dates with people. Like, how are y'all doing that? Teach me. How? Because people be like, Nicole, you're pretty. You be going. Yeah, I know you be going on dates. No, I don't. I'm in the same boat. Valentine's Day, I made that playlist for me. Nah, but like I'm great where I'm at. I'm not gonna lie. What? I never hurt your feelings. Haha. Good morning. Nicole, stay with the roster. What? I don't have a list of guys. I can't tell you how many guys I've had a crush on, but I can tell you I can count on my hand how many guys I've had a crush on and they made me think that they had a crush on me back and they hurt my feelings. But I'm not here to be distracted. Let me refocus. Happy Black History Month. I've been told I'm a lover, not a heartbreaker. Listen, I don't like to be on either side of that. I don't like to be the heartbreaky or the heartbreaker. They both feel equally as horrible. I've been on both sides at least once. It's a common thing. While the shipping options don't show the U.S. That you may be on the the UK site. There is a U.S. site. So if it's not taking you to the U.S. site, just type in the UDI. And it has a site specifically for the U.S. so you can ship it. I've been told I'm a good cook. So have I. I'm an amazing cook. I love to cook. So that don't faze me. Stay out of my kitchen. I'm kidding. High school, college sweethearts into marriage is what we all deserve. I wish. No, I don't. Because the guys that I had on a crush on in high school and in college have both equally turned out to be assholes. So I'm kind of, for the most part, for the guys that it did not work out with, I'm very grateful because it would not have worked if it worked. It would have not. It would, like, that didn't make no sense, but it, yeah. And you said get a regular size. I'm 6'4". Is regular good? Yeah. Yes, sir. Yes, it is. Yes, that's right. It will work. It's actually like all size, one size fits all. They're all fucking huge. But if it's giving you options and you're very tall, then you can get the largest size. You'll be fine. Again, growth. That's growth. Y'all, let me finish this video.
Right. I only like asked that because I grew up Catholic, so I thought I was going to save myself for...
You still watching this video? Jen, we were having a very good conversation in between segments, so mind your beeswax.
Marriage too, and I grew up thinking like it's gonna be a beautiful magical thing that's only meant for my husband, and then it obviously just didn't work like that. And so after that happened, I kind of had a weird relationship with sex for a while, but then it changed my perspective on it a lot. And I was like, it's just like a normal thing that people can do. And so I didn't really want to put it on a pedestal as much as I had before.
There's a lot of gray matter when it comes to virginity now. I know a person out there that she didn't want to be a non-virgin anymore. She didn't want to have sex, so she let him put in, you know, do anal instead.
Actually, in our religion, doing anal is prohibited. It's like not allowed. So anal is not even a, like anal is not allowed. but for me, like if you were to like lose your virginity, it would be a man and a woman having intercourse. There's no gray area.
For me, virginity is whatever you think it is or whatever you consider it to be. Losing your virginity can be, why is my dog howling? Losing your virginity can be anywhere from actual penetration to oral. So whatever to you is what virginity is what virginity is. If you've had oral sex and you still consider yourself a virgin, you're a virgin. If you've had penetrative sex and you still consider yourself a virgin, you're a virgin. Okay? You may have physically had sex before, but like if it wasn't mentally right for you, you can still be a virgin. You can lose your virginity when it feels right. My dog is howling. What's going on with Remy? Anyway, but that's how I see it. If it don't matter what y'all do. If you're a virgin, you're a virgin. But what they talked about, it's still sex. It's still sex. You can still have. It's still sex.
It's interesting that
it definitely is still sex.
In different cultures and religions too.
Yeah.
So that's why it's kind of weird to be.
You can say I'm a virgin, but I've had sex before. Remy, like, where my lover at? Remy don't give a fuck. He doesn't even think he's a dog. He doesn't care. He want his bone. That's what he wants, that fucking bone that I won't let him have because he be eating it too fast and it's gone. I just bought it. He said, anal is some crazy shit. Hey, it's only crazy to people who think it's crazy. That was not implying my stance on it, okay? I was not implying my stance. I'm just saying that sex is a very... What's the word that I'm looking for? It's a labyrinth of things for people, okay? It means different stuff for everybody. Let's just put it at that. I don't think sex... When you're comparing people, I don't think sex has a definition for the same definition. Physical, like being physical has a definition, like scientifically what's going on is a definition, but it's a different meaning for everybody. you can have sex with someone and not be physical. Like there's non-physical sex. If you can mind fuck somebody, intricate layered, yes, it can be very complex. That's the word that I'm looking for. But yes, you also hit it on the nail. But if you can mind fuck somebody, that shit's powerful. You got a lot of power if you can do that to somebody. Hey, read up on that shit. Read up on it. If you can mentally screw somebody, and not in a bad way, in a good way. If you can mentally make love to somebody, that is some top tier, high vibrational, big daddy energy type shit. But we won't get into that topic. That's another topic for another day, because that is that. Hey, all I'm saying is, With life comes experiences, okay? People be having nipple sex. What the fuck? What do? They just both get a nipple and just Twitch, I'm sorry. Yo, Goofy, we can't be in the same room, because you can be acting a fool and I'm gonna encourage it. I'm gonna be laughing. This is why we could not rob a store together. Role play. We cannot rob a store together because you gonna get stuck at the cash register and I'll be hollering. I'll be like, how the fuck you ain't get that open? That's bad. I'm going to float. Mm-mm. I'm just saying, if your sexual skills go beyond the physical, then you are one skilled and one powerful person.
I
miss DreamCon.
Virgin, not virgin. Because we all believe different things. We all believe different things.
Exactly. Yo, so this year, we're going
to
turn up for
I don't even know how to answer the question because I don't agree with virginity.
We was vibing. Hey, this time, we going to eat for real. We going to have some actual food.
As a word or a concept.
You and Joe is going through it. I'm going to cook for y'all. I'm going to cook.
Being open,
I promise, I'm going to cook for y'all.
What I have and haven't done is more important than being yeah, I'm a virgin.
I just do what I want. Whatever I feel is
She said, now I do what I want. Now I do what I want.
Yeah. Comfortable for me, so.
I have been judged for my sexual or non-sexual choices.
That house was lit. We got to get something we gotta get something that big again. Pause. Wait.
Would you look at that?
You said Nicole's laugh is business of the year.
You can't do anything thanks without being
judged. I swear my laugh is annoying as fuck, but thank you.
Oh my god.
What? Where? There is times.
Call me baby boy. Thank you for follow.
And then now I look at it. I was dumb, an idiot. You know, because when I was.
I think at some point everybody judged other people that had sex. They was like, ew. You did what? You're a whore. Oh my god, are you pregnant? Like everybody did that shit. But I think we've grown enough as a people, as a society, for the most part. Oh, no, I wouldn't even say that. This generation, our generation is more conscious about people doing what the fuck they want to do.
Judging, I was probably in high school.
We getting the same one?
It was just very
honestly,
immature.
That was a good Airbnb. So and I wouldn't be mad at it.
I have hindsight with it. It makes me think why is there
but I'm coming over to cook. I gotta go get groceries.
This question gives me a lot of anxiety. Because I have been called slut, whore. That doesn't bother me. Oh, but my experience is a little different because when I was assaulted and I started talking about it, I had to talk to my mom. And she kind of asked me well, why did you get in the car? Why were you at his house?
And you felt
putting more of the blame on me, which is really difficult because.
Damn it.
She's my mom and she's sorry.
Yeah. Okay.
You want a free meal? No, sir, you're paying.
She's supposed to take care of me and uplift me. And it's just hard because I go to her with this huge thing that happened to me and just for her to react why would you do that? It's I don't understand why that was my fault.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And everyone always tells me it's not your fault. And I know that it's just.
You cook vegan? Yes.
It's hard.
Yes,
sometimes I'll get caught up in being oh, I guess it was my fault because I did choose to date him and I did stay. But to my credit,
he was vegan, lactose, pescatarian,
and
all that.
Abusive and sexually abusive. So I didn't know how to leave. And I
grew up thinking like, oh, you date to marry. And so I wanted to make it work so badly. And so that's like why I stayed, and like, I just wanted it to work out. And that's how like I was just taught. And so then like after the whole experience, I was like, I guess like I need to be able to like take care of myself and set my own boundaries and know when to leave. And it sucks that I had to learn it the hard way, but at least I know now. And I know it's not my fault. And like,
I swear this next generation of parents is going to be so understanding. You said dead ass, like real shit. How much for a plate when everyone touched down for DreamCon? Hey, listen, I'm not going to charge you for real. I'm not going to charge. Anyone who slides is going to play it. I'm cooking a lot because I love to cook. So, I mean, if you want plate, I'm making a plate. I don't know what I'm gonna make yet, but it's gonna be good regardless.
It is like something.
Make a meal plan. Yo, I'm coming out with a cookbook. That's what I'm gonna do. That's what I'm gonna do. You guys, I'm gonna drop a cookbook
and like be better with it.
Mm-hmm. Thank you for sharing.
Yeah.
Probably have a different experience than most of you guys, or I guess all of you, but like with being so open about being asexual, like there's not many people who talk about it, especially online, even in real life and everything. And I feel like I've been like immensely judged for it. And even in my videos about being like asexual, primarily on TikTok, I get like,
oh my god, Gitu, what's up, queen?
Being like, you just can't have sex, like you're ugly, like you wouldn't get laid, like you're a blue-haired girl.
How
like,
you doing, Gitu?
Even for me,
I miss like, you.
I'm a strong person. I feel like it's hard to get thousands of people telling you this is fake. And even for me, sometimes it's like, is this fake?
Y'all
like everyone else feels this way. Why do I feel this way? And sometimes even for me, it can get like hard and be like, damn, like, am I broken? Which I know is not true at the end of the day, but.
Yeah, I think for me, I've been judged by like society or like my peers that, oh, she's a virgin. Like, why? Like, you know, it's everything. But it's just like the Western point of view or whatever that like, oh, you never had to first kiss? Like, why haven't you kissed anyone yet or something like that?
Yo, I didn't have my first kiss until fucking college.
And I was like, oh, well, I'm not allowed to.
And it was horrible because homeboy that I kissed, his breath was foul. It was rank.
Well, that's supposed to, you know, like, I don't know. Like, in
overhyped. Case, like, 0 out of 10 will not kiss anybody ever again.
And it was just harder for me to explain, accept that about myself. But then, you know, as you grow older and you understand that people are just different.
Not to say that I wasn't. I learned about. I learned about shit at an age I shouldn't have, though. So, y'all want to know something weird about me? Okay. So, I didn't really kiss anyone or do anything. I barely held hands with anyone. However, I was exposed to learning about things that I shouldn't have been learning about at a very young age. And for some people, it's traumatizing. For other people, they see it and they get curious about it. So something bad happened. I was like in middle school and I accidentally I found out you was watching Prawn. Man, yes, not on purpose though. I was at church, right? This is a wild ass story. This is a we done with this video. This is a wild ass story, but basically when I was younger at church, yes, I was at church. Now let me explain because I know it sounds crazy, but let me explain. So this was like when computers were first like popping, and I was very young, and our church had a Nicole's bonkers. Hear me out. So this is when my church had a not youth. It was like Sunday school. Church had Sunday school. And often we use the computers. This is a very innocent story. It was the pop-up. Yes. So we had Sunday school. Sunday school, all the time we would go on the computer, do like a Jesus program, like a Jesus game. it was a game of the Lord. We would play a game. And it would be like a scavenger hunt on the computer or like a word puzzle or like some kind of program. And then on this one particular day, we were doing a web scavenger hunt where we were supposed to look up Bible verses, right? We were supposed to look up these Bible verses. And it was so contradictory because lo and behold, as I'm looking up, I don't even remember what verse I was on. I was like on Psalms or some shit. I was starting to get to Revelation. Jesus game. I'm sorry, that's what we were playing. But lo and behold, on the side of one of the web browsers, there was like this advertisement, right? This advertisement, and the people did not have no clothes on. So I got scared. I was like, "What? What is that real?" So I clicked on it, and there was a website of all of it. And I was like, what is that? I was like, she actually has her shirt off, like, in front of people. That's what they look like. So that is when one of the teachers came in, and she looked at me, and I was like, and she was like, oh, no! And, like, she literally pulled me aside, and she was like, I'm so sorry you had to see that. And I didn't get in trouble because she obviously thought that it was an accident, which it was. But she was like, I'm so sorry you had to see that. I'm so sorry. And she, like, clicked out of it and, like, wiped it and, like, turned it off. And she was like, everyone, we're not doing computers no more. We're doing a crossword puzzle. We're going to color, okay? And after that, I went home. I went home. And my Nona had left me home alone. So I was like, what was that that I saw at church? So I Googled. I was like, why did I see a woman with her top off? And the search engine just took the last four words, woman with her top off. And five words. And it just took me to a bunch of, like, pages. And I looked at them all. I was like, wow. And that is where I was like, dear heavens. And it got into different categories. And it got into different, like, body parts. And I was just like, and I was like, what is that? And it said the word penis. And I'd never seen that word before. So I was in a car, right? I forgot what the word. I said, I was in the car with my aunt. I was like, auntie, what's a peanut? And she was like, you know what a peanut is. And I was like, no, but this is a different kind of peanut. Like boys have this one. And she goes, a penis? And I was like, yeah. And she was like, shut the fuck up. She turned the music all the way up. She turned it all the way up and drove us to school. She was like, I'm not trying to hear you right now. She turned it up. And I was like, I thought it was a reasonable question. He said, "Innocent Nicole is adorable." I was like, I was very open. I was like, what? I was like, what? And then, so then I went home. I looked it up for myself, but it wasn't on my computer. It was on my aunt's computer. So she looked at her search history. She was like, she pulled me aside. She was like, "What are you doing on this computer?" And I'm like, "I'm looking up stuff." And she was like, "What are you watching?" And I'm like, "Nothing." And she was like, "Okay, well, I knew it was you because the first search word was peanut, and then it just went, it got worse from there." She knew it was me because the first word, the first history, the first, like, page on the history was peanut. And then the next one was, like, boys peanut. It was just a downward spiral from there. We need some childhood pictures. You want to see a picture of me when I was a baby? It's one on my Instagram. I don't think I have, like, my photo album. I think it's at my grandma's house. Yeah, it's at my Nona's house. When I find it, I'll show it for you next stream. But, like, just know that most of my childhood photos is me getting into some shit. Like, I don't know why they always took photos of me, like, doing shit. Like, I remember there's one picture of me at Chuck E. Cheese, like, mid-throw of a ball from the ball pit. I was like, and they just took that picture, and it was just like, this child just be doing shit. I just be like, he said, dog, when I heard the word bitch for the first time, I was 8, and I asked my dad what it was, and he beat my ass. I literally have a same story. I have the same exact story. I didn't know what these cuss words were, but you know that. Okay. All right. Let me give you a visual representation of what happened to me when I was like, I think it was in first grade. It was first grade to be exact. Let me show you what happened. All right. Let me take you back to the year of 2001. Nope, 2000. It was definitely 2000. I was like, yes. Let me give you a visual representation of what happened in the backseat of the car. All right. Imagine me in a car seat, okay? Immediately, the music stopped. I was like, My aunt said, move what? Move what? She said, huh? Move what? Move what? And I was like, get out the way. Get out the way, bitch. Get out the way. And she was like, awesome. She started speeding home. She started speeding. I was like, what's going on? Why are we going so fast? I was like, auntie, stop. And we got to the house. I got to my grandma's house. She was like, I'm going to tell your grandma. I was like, I'm confused. I'm like, what did I do? I'm like, did I do something bad at school? I don't remember. I'm like, what did I do? We get to the house and everything's fine and dandy. And I'm sitting down and I'm like, what is about to happen? And my aunt goes, Mama, guess what your granddaughter said today in the car? And I was like, I was so scared that this was my hiding technique. I ran out of the kitchen, ran into the garage, and hid under the car. I had no other place to hide. Because my grandmother was in the process of renovating the house, so the closet was, like, not vacant at the moment. So I could not hide in the bathroom. I couldn't hide in the closet. I couldn't hide in any of the guest rooms. I hid in the garage under the car. So I was scared I was going to get my ass tore up for not knowing what the fuck I just said. My grandma was like, what did she say? What did she say? And she said, your granddaughter cussing. She said, bitch, today in the car. And she was like, was it on purpose? And she was like, no, it was a song. But she said it. And my granny, she started laughing. She was like, where's she at? Where's that child at? And then she called me. And I was not trying to come up from out the car. So she went to the garage. She was like, no, baby, why are you under the car? And I was like, please don't be mad at me. And she was like, get out from under the car. I was like, I'm sorry. I said, bitch, I didn't know it was a bad word. I'm telling you, I wasn't bad on purpose. I was bad because I was curious and I was always getting myself into shit. I never really, except for that one time. I told y'all about that. But like, for the most part, I'm never doing shit on purpose when I'm getting in trouble. It's curiosity kills the cat, quite literally, because it's just like, I didn't know that was a bad thing. I didn't know I wasn't supposed to do that. You said my nephew cussed when I was in Cali, and I about die laughing. And it's funny because when little kids cuss, that should be, it's like, no! But like, when they do it, that's why I'm kind of scared to be a parent, because it's just like, if my kid ever just started cussing, like on accident too, I will be on the floor. I don't think I would have it in me enough to in that moment teach them that that's not right. I would be on the floor first. I would have to excuse myself. I have to tell my husband, take care of this. I'll be right back. I'm gonna go outside and I'm gonna holler. I will holler. I can't laugh in front of him because that's gonna enable their behavior, but I will be dying of laughter. You said, we were walking out of Dave and Buster's and my sister was talking and said, bitch. Simultaneously, he was trying to say bushes. But his wires got crossed and he said, bitches. I can't even begin to tell you how that's happened to me before. And I'll be like, and I wouldn't get in trouble because my parents knew what I was trying to say. But like, when I tell you, I feared for my life. So I was only like halfway listening, but I heard, look at those bitches. Look at those bitches. When I finally realized that how bad cussing was and I started to do it in like on purpose in private, literally I was like, 1, 2, 3, I want those bitches. 4, 5, 6, 7, yes, I want those bitches. And that's how it was. After I learned about cussing for real, I was like, I'm Mr. Bitches. Yes. Yes, that's right. And I started like cussing for real in like middle school. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. But I would be quiet. I'd be like, what the fuck? So I wouldn't say that out loud. You said, yo, you ever seen that video of the little kid telling his teacher, shut up, bitch? Yes! In, like, that classroom. He was like, shut up, bitch. And then I was like, hey. I was like, no, he clearly knew what that meant. Because he said it on purpose. He knew what that meant, one. Two, kids often repeat what they hear. So it's also something going on with the parents, too, saying shit like this around him. Enabled it. There's a lot going on in that video. You said, when I was younger, I used to hump my hand and my mom found me one time and beat my ass. I didn't know. I usually don't like to reflect on those childhood memories. But, yeah. I'm sorry that she found out. Hey, when I was younger, I used to practice making out with my pillow. I got walked in on by my father too. By my father. It wasn't great. I was trying to pretend like I was asleep. However, you can't really pretend like you're asleep when you're sitting up. So because my dad came in to tell me that it was time to eat. He was like, hey, come here. Hey. That's how that happened. That's how my dad did. He was like, hey. that's how he fussed at us. Was, hey. And I was like, I was just smelling it. You said, Nicole, I was having a whole concert at DreamCon acting like I was in the after party last year turning. Hey, I didn't go to that after party either. We went to the fucking studio. And I wish we didn't. You have me rolling over here. What's up, hoodie thief? I'm sorry. I know I be talking about bullshit. I know I be talking about BS. Predison making out with it. I did it on my pillow. I did it on my hand. I did it with the wall. I don't like to be by that wall no more. But it wasn't this wall. Not this wall. But it was a wall. Which is very difficult to do because to be able to make out with a wall is, that's not easy. So all my uncles were DJs, so cussing started early. You said stunting is a habit. Get like me. Oh, brother. You said, I feel like I got to avoid all the parties at DreamCon, mostly because I don't want to catch COVID, but also because I don't want to be sleepy. Yeah, I think I've started to turn into an old lady, which I'm not mad about because, like, parties, like, big-ass parties at this point in time, I'm just like, I would rather go to bed. Respectfully, I would rather go to bed. I met up with my door. That is another level. I've never met up with my door before. I met up with my stuffed animal. Mm-hmm. We sold them at a garage sale. So whoever has that stuffed animal, you know, has my lipstick on it, my lip gloss. Looking up boys' peanuts, kissing pillows, walls. Hey, listen, I was a very curious child. Luckily enough for me, I never made it to the dark web. Something be chilling in my Airbnb, like eating, smoking, and drinking. Yes, I will, however, be cooking. Kiss from Brazil. Oh my God! Thank you. I appreciate you. Kiss from Texas. I've always wanted to go to Brazil. You speak Portuguese? I understand Portuguese. I don't speak it very well, but I know a little bit about some Portuguese. He said, although I have a checklist, I got to go salsa dancing at least once and ride a mechanical bull while I'm in Texas. Mm-hmm. You know what's crazy? I chipped my tooth on a mechanical bull, so be careful. I was pondering what the dark web is. No, you're not. Stop lying. I'm serious. I chipped the tooth. I chipped the tooth. Just be careful. Or if you plan on doing it, wear a mouth guard. I chipped a tooth. Had to get that baby filled. Had to get a crown on it. You know? I can tango. It's pretty. I was going to learn how to tango. I dance. But I've never learned how to tango. I know how to waltz. I do know how to waltz. I do tap dance. Oh my God, y'all. It's below freezing. I'm not going outside. Sounds like something you pull off. What? Get my tooth chipped? That was years ago. That was a long time ago. If you made it to the dark web, we probably wouldn't be watching you right now. Literally, I probably wouldn't be streaming. I wouldn't be streaming. Yeah, I would say a lot of shit to get me in trouble. You said, dark web is only cool to get weed and bulk like I'm scamming a thing. Not just weed. Shoes as well. No, dark web, don't go there. Don't. Hey, I'm listening. I'm trying to tell you because I've been. Not when I was younger, thank God. But in the past 5 years, I have witnessed. I have not actively gone there, but I've witnessed the dark web. Yeah, so don't try to hack me. My IP is not out there. I've witnessed someone going onto the dark web, and I watched them do it, and it was nuts. It was a very wild situation. Yeah, there's no joke there. Don't do that. Don't do that. Don't do that. It's a very elaborate, large place that is compiled of things that you never want to see. Story time. I don't think there's a story there. Just don't. No story. Only trauma. Only trauma. I feel like I, at this point, and which is sad, I've seen so much that I've seen enough. I've seen it all. Don't do it. Dark web is a portal to hell? Yeah, no thanks. I would never go there willingly. Mm-mm, nope. The fact that it exists. Anyway, y'all be safe on these interwebs. People are strange. People, what the dark web has taught me is that people on this world are strange and weird and evil. Like, there are some really evil people because there's nobody else on the dark web but other humans. So, I just want you to know that people are strange. People are fucking scary. Which is another reason why I don't like to leave my house. You said, Nicole, you're going to summon the wrong people out of Twitter. And what they going to do? Sub? Hey, subscribe. I talk about these things all the time. You said aliens? Yo, aliens are cool as fuck. Now, that is something I wouldn't mind seeing. I'd rather see an alien before I see anything on the dark web. In fact, I don't even have to make a decision. I want to see aliens now, so... If I were to see another UFO, and that's another story time for another day, because I have seen one. For all you non-believers out there, I have seen a UFO. Not saying it was an alien spaceship, but it was definitely an unidentified flying object. Me and my dad saw it. He can tell you the story himself. However, I would like to see another one. Here goes the UFO shit. I'm just saying. Fantasy, thank you for the raid. Yo, I'm finna get off. Thank you. Goes offline. Man, thank you so much for the raid. I appreciate you, dude. I hope you had an amazing stream. I really do. That shit scared me. I hope you had an amazing stream, man. You said, right, we need to bring lights to the world. I feel like everyone being quarantined either enhanced your good or enhanced your evil because you're constantly alone with your thoughts and energy. Mm-hmm. I agree. But yeah, definitely do want to see... So have you ever played Welcome to the Game? No, but I've seen some gameplay and it looks horrifying. I need that alien DLC loaded right now. Literally, I want to come into contact with some aliens. Because the last time I saw a UFO, I was driving. But the first time I saw a UFO, I was with my dad. And we were in the bed of his truck because he was chopping wood for the wintertime. So he was chopping wood. It had gotten dark. So we ate. We sat in the back of the truck, listened to some music, and just ate. And he had his little telescope. So, yes, we were looking for shooting stars, which you can actually see in certain parts of Texas because there's wide open area. There's no smoke in the sky. There's no smog in the air. So there's many times that my dad and I, we went to go look up at stars. And I've seen like 3 shooting stars in my life. And it was a very beautiful experience. So I would definitely, if you can do that in your state, go do it. Be careful, but go do it. But we would skywatch. And me and my dad, yo, we were looking up. And I was like, that one close. And he goes, give me that telescope. And he looked up, he looked at me. He was like, take a look. And I looked at it and it was just sitting there just floating. And this was the time I was little, so this was before drones, like the sky drones technology. This was before drones. So I'm just looking, I'm like, what is that? Is that a helicopter? He was like, ain't got no wings. It wasn't a helicopter. No, it wasn't one of them. It was just sitting there. And you know how if an object is flying, it like does this, it like hovers. It wasn't doing that. It was just straight. Like it was stuck in the sky, like it flew in and it stuck. and after we watched it for so long, it spun and there was like really pretty dotted lights on the out. It was an angel. It could have been anything. I'm not saying, I never said it was an alien spaceship. I just said it was a UFO. There's a difference. There are some people that believe that a UFO automatically means a spaceship, and that's not what it means. It literally just means an unidentified flying. Fuck! Damn! It means unidentified flying object. So that's what it was. We just didn't know what it was. I don't know if it was aliens. I don't know. To this day, I don't know what it was. Me and my dad could not figure it out. We were questioning it the entire time. But I couldn't see it all. It was like pitch black. Like the object itself was black and it had little lights at the bottom of it. Like, and it was just like, it was spinning, but it was like stuck in the sky. It was Nicole's people. If they don't come back and come get me, why they leave me here? Why did they leave me here? But shit, if I were to see another, I'm running towards and I'm telling them to come get me. Huh. Uh-huh. For real this time, because I'm sick of y'all. Believe in aliens? I believe there's something other than humans. Because they chose you for the job. You're right. I gotta fulfill my duties before they come get me again. I have to finish the objective and then they'll come get me. You said, Nicole, you know what's crazier than this UFO story? I already feel like it's finna be some BS KJ's finna say to me. It has to be aliens out there. Right. I like these ads. Oh my God. You should probably sub. KJ, you should probably sub up to the channel. I mean, that's not a crazy concept to me if you had a halo. I believe in higher beings, not necessarily aliens. If you leave me, then we can't see you no more. No, I can stream from other. I forgot how to do Wi-Fi somewhere else. PG Melvo, thank you so much for the follow. I appreciate you. Just advanced humans. I believe that there are infinite galaxies. Okay, first of all, there's so many galaxies. There's so many realities. It gotta be more life out there. It can't be radio silent out there. It can't be. And there's different realms. There's different, like, there's a 3D realm. There's a 4D, 5D. Man. Hey, what's up, new here? Welcome. It's nice to meet you. It's nice to meet you. My name is Nicole. We're just having a little comfy chat before I head to bed. It can't be just us. Ain't no way. That's what I'm saying. I hope you're having a good night, by the way. Thank you for coming in to chat it up. It's nice to meet you. It's Martians for sure. Wait, doesn't Martians just mean there's life on Mars? Or what is the actual definition of a Martian? Is that different from an alien? Hoodie thing. Oh boy, I can't read. Thank you so much for the follow. I appreciate you. It said cats have 9 lives because they see all 9 realms. So what? Is that true? Martians are from Mars. Okay, that's what I thought. Is that true? I thought that was just a saying that cats have 9 lives because they like they're very like stealthy, or they're very good at getting themselves out of near death experiences. Cause cats, yo, cats be shit. the cat that lives across the street from me, I swear that cat was gonna get hit by a car like 8 times because he just literally just be chilling in the street, and it's the neighbor's cat, but he's one of those cats that they let roam around the neighborhood because he comes back. Like, he knows where his house is, but they let him roam. He don't have no collar on or nothing. And he just be in the street, and I'm like, psst, 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 come here, get out the street. And cars be coming, and a car would be just like this, and he kind of blend in with the street, so you can't see him. Right when they get to him, he be out the way, and I'm like, you little sneaky shit. I would be like horrified if I was a cat owner, because they don't be giving a fuck. He said there's a story long time ago of a cat that literally died and came back to life 9 times. Are you serious? Was that cat in Egypt? Why do I feel like I heard of that story? Will it do like adrenaline? Right! I'm not an adrenaline junkie. You said there's many different solar systems within our galaxy alone. Now, take into account that there are several, maybe infinite galaxies with several solar systems of their own. There's no way we are the only living beings in the universe. Yes, exactly. 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 And we exist because our planet is the perfect distance away from the sun to not be too hot or be too cold, so we can survive here. So I know there's another solar system out there where there's a planet the perfect distance away from the sun to where life like us can thrive on it, because there's infinite galaxies. So we just a little too far away. We too fucking far. I'm not going to space, though. You can't get me to go up there. Hell no. Mm-mm. I'm staying right where I can see the floor. I'm not going up there. That's one of my biggest fears, is going into space. It's too fucking huge up there, and there's no floor. Mm-mm. You fall, you're falling for the rest of your life. You said, do you think you retain information more when you say it yourself instead of hearing someone else say it? I had to say it out loud multiple times. I love for these conversations. Same. I believe in a parallel universe and shit. Yeah, I believe that. I believe in jumping in between realities. I believe that when we die, we're too advanced in consciousness to, like, just be gone. I feel like we live infinitely. We've been here before. Well, we may not have been here, but we've been around before. I believe that we're infinite beings. But yeah. That's just my belief. I do believe, like, I don't know. I was raised Christian, so of course I believed in heaven and hell. However, as I got older, I started to question more things, and I started to explore different possible beliefs. I started to explore different facts of life, and I learned a lot more. And I personally swayed away from Christianity. I find myself to be very spiritual. However, Christianity itself didn't define what I was. It didn't. For me, Christianity didn't define what I was believing. So I started to look into more possibilities of ourselves as a species. So I believe that the earth is constantly jumping. Like, it's always jumping. But yeah, I believe that we are infinite, a sort of infinite kind of being, that we may physically die, but we're too conscious to, like, just disappear completely out of the fucking matrix. What the fuck? He said, jumping timelines, jumping realities, constantly recycling our consciousness. Yeah, yeah. That's why I say at the end of all this shit, all this material stuff can go away, but I feel like we take something with us. You said, and Nicole, I'm on the same path as you for sure. I don't even know if there's a religion around what I believe in. Like Little Red Riding Hood, yes. There may be, I just don't know the name for it. Or the name for my belief. You said, I look at all religions as moral guides and nothing more. Mm-hmm. Allegories, yeah. I'm too sober for this shit. Oh, you say you can't have a conscious conversation without being consciously here? It's crazy, KJ. But this conversation would hit stoned. It's RP Twitch. You're making your own religion? Yes. It's called Nicoleology. Study it. And then bow down, bench. I run this shit. I run this shit. You said, do you ever wonder if there is a mirror world? Like some kind of, like, Doctor Strange type shit? Maybe. I have no idea what's possible. I feel like there's so many infinite possible things that could happen. I found a religion where I could literally be worshipped. I did too. Okay, I don't know if y'all know this. I'm gonna link it to y'all. But you can literally buy land. You can, there. I think it's in the UK. You can go online and sign up for it. You can buy land, and you will be the lady or the lord of that land. And it's like a few acres. You can get a deed and everything. And you can build on it, do whatever you want. You are literally the lady or the lord of that land, like in old times. And you can literally start your own religion and register it, and it will be your religion, and people can follow it and fucking worship you if they want to follow you, which sounds like something Marilyn Manson would do. However, he didn't get land, so it wasn't registered. And you see yourself and then walking away, your reflection walks away. I can't really explain it through text. That sounds like something I experienced having a lucid dream. Look up what? Odontology? Odontology? I'm gonna look that. Wait, let me bookmark that, because I'm gonna look that up after stream. It just fit the bill. That actually sounds mad interesting. Oh, not for me to start anything, but I want to look into it. I want to see, like, what goes into that. Life is a religion itself? I like that. That's a bar. That is absolutely a bar. But yeah, I'm not really, I wouldn't call myself religious. The way that I move on this earth is through energy. I'm very, very big on exchanging. Every interaction I have is an exchange of energy with someone. So I very see myself as a very energy wielding spiritual being that is more than just a physical body. I feel like I have a higher consciousness that will continue to thrive after this body will be gone away. But that's not a Twitch conversation. You said, Nicole Van Houten and Twitch stream calls. Okay. When you worship me, everyone will go live at the same time and we will say the same phrase and we will summon the Twitch God. Yes. Yes. I don't believe in interreligion at all. And you don't have to believe in interreligion at all. Or you can believe in multiple. Looks like I'm buying land. You finna be the lord of your land? I wanna come to your land. I'm definitely getting acres. I'm definitely getting acres. Definitely. I'd wife you for real. Where my ring at? Where's my ring? Go ahead. Pass me that ring. Hey. The day that I get married, that would be a... Just know that means I'm in love for... Just know that means I'm in love. You say, hey, I already got her ring. Whoever brings me the ring first. Because multiple people got rings. But whoever presents the ring to me first. Y'all ever watch that one... I think it's a Studio Ghibli movie. About that princess who she was like the most... Everyone wanted to marry her. Especially like other princes from different kingdoms. So all she was like this princess. And it's a Japanese story. All these princes... heard about her, came to her and wanted to marry her. So they all came together. We watched this in Discord, I think. They all came to want to marry her. And she didn't want to marry any of them. It was like an arranged marriage. She didn't want to marry any of them, but they all were trying to say how beautiful she was and how much they wanted her and how much like they'd do anything for her. So she said, they didn't even know what she looked like cuz she stood behind like this thing. Good night. She stood behind like this thing. No one knew what she looked like. But all these princes wanted to marry her. She was like, okay. And all these princes was like, I will go scavenge the seven seas and bring back the most beautiful jewel to present it to you for your hand in marriage. And this guy was like, oh, I can do better. I will go kill a dragon and take like a scale off of his neck and present it to you and for your hand. They was talking all big shit. He was like, I'm a prince. I can do that for you. And she was like, all right. All of y'all go do it. She was like, all of y'all go do it. Go talk about this mystical gem that you would bring back for me. He was like, what? I was like, wait, what? And she was like, go do it. Go bring back this gold thread that is so rare that no one can touch it, blah, 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 that it costs so much money. Go get me that dragon scale. Go get me that expensive thing that's in the sea. And whoever brings it back to me, I'll marry him. And that was like, ain't no fucking I was like, you asked me to go do that. That's literally impossible. You said I'm worth that much, right? So go get it. And I forgot the name of that movie. I'm going to ask Joni because she's the one that put it on for us. I'm going to go find it because that's a really good fucking movie. You said, and men will really have to bring back a rare Infinity Stone. But they were lying. That's the underlying thing. They were lying. They didn't want to marry her because she was that much of value. They want to marry her because if they got married to her, like their value will go up. You're priceless, right? That's a good movie. I'm gonna find the name of that movie and we watching it. It's good. It was beautiful. It was a beautiful movie. Kind of find out she wasn't even a princess for real. So you get married in 2076. Why do you see why do you see me getting married so far away in the future? I might be getting married sooner than you think. I'm kidding. But that being said, it's almost 1:30 in the morning. I usually don't stream this song, but I actually started late, so I do stream this song. But thank y'all for hanging out with me. I love just having... Last time we had it mainly just chatting, like, stream, a little bit of gamage, but... I enjoy talking to y'all. I like getting to know y'all. Y'all are some interesting people. She dead ass probably have a baby. That's for me to know. I'm not telling y'all if I do. But we are going to raid Tamia because she's online right now and thinks she's playing Game of Thrones. So y'all go show some love to Tamia. Thank y'all for hanging out with me tonight. If you're interested in getting an hoodie, go ahead and use that code. The code should be valid for a while. So yes, thank y'all for hanging with me. I love you guys. As always, seek love, seek peace, take care of yourself, eat your fruits, eat your vegetables, drink your water, and just love each other, love yourselves, spread positivity. You guys are some lovely people and I appreciate you guys so much. So go show Tamia some love, hit her with a follow, tell her I said I love her, and y'all have an amazing night. I'll see y'all tomorrow. We're gonna be playing a lot of new stuff with some awesome familiar faces, so I'll be seeing you guys very soon. If not tomorrow, then definitely this weekend for sure. So her whispers are off, I think. Oh, okay. Wait, is she like follower only? Nicole wants 5 kids. That's crazy. You know what's crazy is how you show me what you're gonna say whenever I raid someone and y'all say like the most nutty ass shit. Like, I don't see that. I want 9. Get it right. I want 9 kids. Good night.